Hello, and welcome to Malwarebytes How-To's. Users in your Malwarebytes OneView console range from other staff at the managed service provider who will deploy to endpoints, to customer representatives who only want visibility on how it's working, and every role in between. To view all users, log into the OneView console, expand the settings menu, and click Users. Here, you see the user's roles. Global administrators have unrestricted access to the OneView console and all customer sites within. Only global administrators are able to manage policies and exclusions for any sites. Site administrators have view and edit access to all customer sites they have been assigned. Customer administrators can manage their site's endpoints, detections, and quarantine, but cannot affect the setup of the site. This is an appropriate role for a customer representative who will take an active role. Viewers, as the name implies, have view-only access to the sites they are assigned. See this table for more information on role types. You can search for a user by clicking here, sort by clicking on the name of any column, and create a new user here. Fill in the name and email. Each user must have a unique email address. But if you need to test out multiple user perspectives, you can append with a plus sign to act as a unique email. Also, fill in the role and decide whether they have access to Active Response Shell. Active Response Shell, which allows users to address attacks and detections on remote endpoints, is only available for global administrators. You can assign the user to their customer sites now or return at a later point to do so. The newly created user will receive an email to confirm their account. Until they confirm, their status will be pending. If a user is struggling to find this email, you can resend the invite. Lastly, here you control whether two-factor authentication is required for all users. After confirming their email and logging in, your users can view or manage customer sites, depending on their permissions. If you have any questions, please visit service.malwarebytes.com.